Nick, you and I have waited all year for this. It's the most exciting, action-packed 2 weeks in all of sports, and it tips off in today's game between the North Texas Mean Green and the Purdue Boilermakers.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all the other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
Nick, if you were coaching either one of these teams, what would your points of emphasis be?
First off, encourage all players to be somewhat aggressive at the offensive end. Spread out the attack. Secondly, fatigue makes a coward out of all of us. Substitutions must be made. Lastly, box out. When the shot goes up, put your body on a man and get inside position.
And it's time for the tip-off. And with the tip, we're underway here in the first half. Dumps it in. Tries for two. Perfectly executed.
Look at that! That's unbelievable, baby!
Gave it up. He goes with a jump hook.
I tell you, didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position, and then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
Number three takes the pass. The missed shot. Number three handles the feed.
Dump it inside.
Ten seconds remaining on the shot clock. Nails the deuce. Bucket up and in.
Get out of the way, baby. That was absolutely sensational.
There may be a pick and roll here, Dick.
You've got to love the pick and roll, especially when it's run to perfection, Brad.
No good from the field. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Ten seconds on the clock. Open shot. He misses badly on that three-point attempt. There's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
Well, Brad, as the meter indicates, the game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
The shooting guard with the ball. Dickey still applying great pressure on the dribbler. The ball goes out of play. Ball's coming from the sideline. Number 10 handles the pass. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move. Look at that spacing.
For two, way off target. Number 10 receives the pass. The They'll work it around the arc. Goes up for two.
The land.
Some offensive instruction by the coach. Cross court.
Up and in.
Working it around the perimeter. Two, perfectly executed. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. For the bucket. They still don't score. The outside. For two. Perfectly executed. Both teams looking to get things going here. Here comes a pick.
Hey, ball screens are such an important part of the game these days. Guys are so creative when it comes to using that ball screen.
As we continue to track the game's tempo.
Two teams are picking and choosing when they want to push the ball, Brad.
They're working around the perimeter. He shoots from the top of the circle. 10 on the shot clock. Moving it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. And in and out. The Mean Greens are definitely a slow it down type of team, Dick, and they're all about clock management and half-court execution.
The moment they get away from this, they aren't as successful.
Number 35 with the ball. On the dribble, gives it up. 10 on the shot clock. Kicks it out. Jumper. He is just lighting it up, Dick.
He's beating his man to the spot and hit the shots, Brad.
Dick, it looks like some of these guys are really getting tired. Now trying to feed the low block. Now the turnaround jumper. He gets the board. Looking for a good shot. Gets the ball and now faces his man that blocks the shot. Number 35's modest performance is bringing down his confidence level.
Hey, well, offensively, he's probably not feeling it. Defensively, he's been a step behind. He's going to have to turn things around.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
The layup.
Blows right by him.
That's the old man of your defense. Let the ball go through.
The small forward gets the pass. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Turnaround jumper. They clear the defensive rebound.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way they'll be able to get some fast break opportunities.
Had a momentary look from three-point land. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
On the outside. Lots of room. He misses the three. And his shot rejected. Perfectly executed. Number three takes the pass. They work it around the perimeter. For two. Up and in. Gets the rejection. Rejects it. Number 32, mediocre play has really gotten to him.
Brad, I see a young man who's struggling at both ends of the court.
He gets the rejection. Off the rim and no good. Number three handles the pass. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
They work the perimeter. With a good look. He's got the stroke.
He missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
For two, the Mean Greens have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
I love the NCAA tournament more than maybe anything else in sports, and I love first halves like this where both teams are playing well.
I'll tell you one thing, quality performances by both clubs. They are really responding and playing right at the right moment. I think that old cliche really jumps here. It's going to be really sad that one of these clubs are going to be bye-bye and out of the NCAA.
Gave it up. Turnaround jumper. He takes the rebound. On the dribble, gives it up. He can't get any more open than that. Tremendous rebound.
These kids are great at positioning themselves for the ball.
Kicks it out. Goes up for two. And off the mark. Timeout on the floor. Well, Dick, it's always important to come out of a timeout with a game plan, I think.
You know, very important. It's a chance to get your team on the same page, talk about what's happened previously and what's about to happen in the future. I hate it when teams come out of a timeout unorganized and without a plan.
He puts up the three ball, gets it to fall. The Mean Greens are definitely a slow-it-down type of team, Dick, and they're all about clock management and half-court execution.
The moment they get away from this, they aren't as successful.
Gets the ball and now faces his man down in the low block.
A very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
Looking for a good shot. Open for a shot. Knocks down the three.
Excellent spacing, that's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards up there.
Yeah, that helps. The lay-in. Now they work it around the perimeter. Tries for two. Up and in.
Up and inside.
With the catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I'll tell you, great spin move to the basket.
The Mean Greens are definitely known for their slower style of play.
This style really calls for heavy players who typically play fundamentally sound, team-oriented basketball. All play styles play team basketball. However, half-court teams rely more on their teammates to score and defend.
Down inside. Go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. He grabs the board. Number 25 takes the pass.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He unloads a three. You betcha. This is getting ugly.
Hey, if you can't check your man, it's up to the coach to recognize that and make an adjustment. Dump it inside.
Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
With a little baby hook, he cleans the glass. Got a guy right on him on the pass. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
The defensive rebound coming the other way.
Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the fast break. Look at that spacing.
He goes with a jump hook. He takes the board. The shooting guard handles the feed. They'll work it around the arc. With all sorts of time. And it's no good from downtown. Well, whose team tempo went out? That's a question right here, Dick.
You know, Brad, tempo is always important. Every team has their philosophy, and it's up to the players to follow the game plan.
Number 14 takes the feed. Gave it up. For the bucket. Off the mark. The point guard takes the pass. Working it around the perimeter. Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's crawling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound in the building.
For two, the lay-in. The Boilermakers prefer a more balanced attack. They play up-tempo at times and then really settling in the half court at other times.
Brad, they like the balanced attack. They don't feel like they can always play up-tempo or always play in the half court. Therefore, they mix it up and do a little bit of both. I think this style works for them.
He tries the three ball. It's no good. On the outside. The student body looks to be full with rage and willing to cheer on the old home team.
The student body looks like they're having some fun out there.
Steal.
Nothing better come easy tonight, baby.
They are really playing for keeps. At the end of the first half, the Mean Green are ahead by 8. Best play of that half. Let's take another look. Nick, what are you seeing so far in terms of points of emphasis?
Brad, I look at the graphic, and there are definitely not enough check marks. That indicates that the team is not playing their style. It's very difficult to win often if you're not playing your style.
They've got to do what they do and play their style. Some great points there, Mr. Vitale. Let's see how they make out in the second half. Purdue is showing little promise from the field in the first half, and Dick, you got to wonder if more of that is coming up in the second half.
Hey, do you think the coach is screaming a little bit down here in that locker room about shot selection? Coaches don't tolerate bad shot selection. He'll make sure it doesn't happen two halves in a row.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Up and in.
West checking courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Aaron. The power forward handles the pass. Inside. With a jumper, the Mean Green have 17 rebounds. They're working around the perimeter.
defender is still applying great ball pressure, Rat.
He passes it out of the trap. 10 seconds remaining on the shot clock. He tries the jumper. What should they do here, Dick?
I'd call a timeout and see what's going on out there. There's definitely some miscommunication happening.
Moving it around the perimeter. Now the turnaround jumper. Brings it down.
And they've got to get out and fill the lanes, Brad.
For the bucket. Lays it up.
Oh, my goodness. That was unbelievable, baby.
On the dribble, gives it up. For the deuce. Perfectly executed. Looking for a good shot. Goes up for two. He got the bucket to go, and he'll have the chance to add one more.
He saw the foul coming, Brad, but he got it up anyway.
Chance for an easy one. Terrible free throw. The center with the ball. Gave it up. They get an open look for three. Scorches the net.
Let's see that up close.
On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two. The lay-in. The small forward with the ball. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Trying to stay with him defensively, and he's going to pick up the foul.
Oh, what a terrific job exploding in the basket. Poor job defensively letting him get the ball that deep.
A little two-man action. Dumps it in for two. Whistled for the foul. And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
Okay, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game.
Steps to the line for the freebie. Makes his first. Gets the second shot. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play.
The point guard gets the pass. Tries for two. Up and in. Number three receives the pass. We're going to move it around the perimeter. Oh, makes the block. The ball goes out of bounds. So the pass will come in from the baseline. Ten seconds showing on the shot clock. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
The Mean Greens
are definitely known for their slower style of play.
I think you need players who really understand the game and know how to get others open, as well as use screens. Typically, they aren't the most athletic guys.
Cross court. Tries for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
The shooting guard handles the pass. Had a momentary look from three-point land. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, field the defensive player.
He hit the deuce, and the foul is called.
Nice job of absorbing the foul and keeping his focus.
Steps to the line for an easy one. He gets it to go. Well, this man's in trouble. Escapes the trouble and makes a pass up. Long pass down court. Passes it out of the trap. He puts up the J.
Jumping didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Gave it up. He takes it away. Here comes the ball screen. For the bucket. He puts in another score.
He can see the light, Brad, and it's hanging right over the goal.
Number three handles the feed. On the dribble, gives it up. For the deuce, the layup. Dick, at defense looks tired.
Hey, that's no excuse. They've got to dig down deep and get the job done.
On the outside. Blocks the shot. The shooting guard handles the feed. To feed the low block. He's all alone. And the ball goes out of play. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover there.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
They work it around the perimeter. On the shot clock. The power forward gets the ball.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
The small forward takes the feed. Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. On the shot clock. The shooting guard gets the pass. He gets the bucket to fall. Number three. The shooting guard gets the ball. Gave it up. He puts it up. There was no doubt about that one. They work the perimeter. Escapes the trouble and makes a pass up. He attempts a jump hook.
I tell you, great job protecting the basketball, getting deep post position, and the jump hook is so effective.
Kicks it out. And the ball goes out of bounds. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad, as you can imagine, I am seeing a completely different attitude on the bench now than I did in the first half. The coaching staff and players, they just have looks of disbelief on their faces.
All right, thanks, Aaron.
Up and in.
The Mean Greens
are all about playing in the half court and controlling the tempo, wouldn't you say, Dick?
When they do those types of things, Brad, they get into a rhythm. Everyone knows that rhythm is crucial for offensive success in basketball or for any sport for that matter. That's definitely a correlation.
For two,
the lay-in.
Number 55 takes the feed. Goes up for two, way off target.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
He lets it fly. He drains the bucket. Dribble, gives it up from the baseline. He's doing a terrible job of distributing the ball.
They may have to pull him out and let somebody else out there, let him think about it for a while.
The power forward gets the ball, takes the rebound.
As soon as you get that defensive rebound, you should be looking to push the ball.
The Boilermakers might be in trouble here, Dick. It might be time to abandon any half-court sets and look at getting some baskets in transition.
Playing in the full court usually isn't their thing, but they're going to have to play in this manner in order to get back into the game.
The Mean Greens
aren't strangers to playing in a half-court game, so at this point, they'll be able to continue playing their style, Dick, and ensure that that clock continues to wind down.
You have to get stops, and you have to execute at the offensive end. Those are two important factors when protecting the lead. It helps even more if playing in the half court is what you do on a regular basis. I tell you, they all want to take it to the rack. High wire rack, baby. Little tipsy-doo dunkaroo.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Goes up for two. Up and in. Looking for a good shot. Three. 10 seconds on the clock. Stolen ball. Here they go into transition. Kicks it out. He's all alone. He launched that from the parking lot.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He takes the board. Number five handles the feed. Now they work it around the perimeter. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Up with the shot. He makes the jumper. This one might go down to the final buzzer.
At this point in the game, clock management and execution are really important. The team that does these things well will win, I guarantee it.
Well, I think the coach is going to have to make some changes here, Dick. The players are starting to look really tired out there. The shooting guard with the ball. With the catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I tell you, great spin move to the basket.
The center handles the pass. Cross court. Turnaround jumper. Weak side rebound. They keep it alive, Dick. Well, the coach doesn't like what he's seeing right now. He's called a timeout. Sideline inbounds.
Up and inside.
Ten seconds on the shot clock. The catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I tell you, great spin move to the basket.
The center handles the feed. For blocks the shot.
I tell you, we've seen some great block shots. Teammates love it. They applaud.
To get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Now the turnaround jumper. 10 on the shot clock. He hits a bullseye again.
Hey, he's feeling it from everywhere, baby.
Up and inside.
Ten seconds showing on the shot clock. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip. Going one way, you spin back the other way.
The power forward takes the feed. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Tries for two. Basket's good, and he got a little charity for his effort.
Hey, he did a good job of keeping himself under control despite the foul.
He'll get an opportunity to change the scoreboard again from the free throw line.
Well, he created a foul opportunity. Look at that spacing.
Takes the wide open shot. Misses from way outside. Cross court. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Picks off the lazy pass. Here they go in transition. For the bucket. You can't be that aggressive. And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock. Possession air timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
I tell you, what an opportunity he's got right here. Because to me, this is a gift.
Got him trapped here, Dick.
Look at that trap, Brad.
Great composure to pass it out of the trap. They look to get it to the inside. Nice move with a face-up.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad. I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
The offense begins off the sideline inbounds. Timeout's called.
Hey, the coach wants to just talk about how they're going to overcome this big deficit.
Get back out on the floor. Trying to feed inside. He shoots from the top of the circle. They get it to go. Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here?
It looks like they're going to slow the game down by fouling Brad.
Opportunity now for an easy one. Makes the front end of the 1-1. Gets the second shot. A great trap initiated by the defense. Passes it out of the trap. The power forward receives the ball. Great composure to pass it out of the trap. Pushes it up. Boy, terrible execution on offense. The shooting guard gets the pass. Picks off the pass. He shoots from the top of the key. He drains the jumper. It's all about playing your team style, Dick. Any final thoughts?
I love these points of emphasis because they are a great guide for teams. Accomplishing most of them will likely result in a win. Staying away from your style will result in a poor performance. To me, Brad, it's an easy decision to make.
Well, Dick, it's all about playing your style and doing the things that your team does well. If you can manage to play your style on a regular basis, you're going to be successful. Sometimes it's just that simple. Dick, you've said it so many times, survive and advance. Well, one survived and will advance. The other one's going home.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
The Mean Green opened the tournament with an impressive first-round victory.
Winning that game was so important. A big first win not only keeps the team's championship hopes alive, but does wonders to calm these kids' nerves entering the second round.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.